The three qualities of a kingdom disciple. The three qualities of a kingdom disciple. So, are you a disciple of the kingdom of God? Yes or no? So, I'm gonna read to you in Luke chapter 14, verse 33. So, likewise, whoever he be of you that forsaketh not all that he hath, he cannot be my disciple. In this verse, we can learn three qualities of a kingdom disciple. Number one, a kingdom disciple is single. Wow, what do you mean by single? You mean single, not having a relationship? It's not talking about that. From the word whosoever in this verse, whosoever, we are. This means that it is talking about an individual. It is talking about a one person or a single human being. It also means anyone. Because being a disciple, not a responsibility, but a one-on-one or a single responsibility of a single person. God, Jesus, while he was ministering on earth, there were lots of people who are following him. Even in Luke chapter 8 verse 4, a large crowd was always coming together to him, because Christ has lots of teachings. But the way Christ teach the crowd, he was telling them in parables. It means that from those crowd, he is telling parables in order to find out who is a single individual who will become interested of his teaching. So in Matthew 5:20, large crowds were gathered to him. Why? Because they need healing. So if you belong to a crowd, you are just coming to Christ in order to get benefits. But a single person or a disciple, a true disciple, is not just interested on what you can get from the Lord or the benefit that you can get from the kingdom, but being a single person and a disciple, you are the person who desires that the Lord will use you in order to spread, in order to further, in order to expand the kingdom of God. So being a disciple is not a group or it's not a crowd responsibility. It's an individual responsibility. Have you noticed the Lord did not call the crowd? Instead, he called individuals just like Philip, Nathaniel. So you can read it in John chapter 1 verse 43 to 51. Because God saw each and every individual, the one who has unique personality, unique characteristic. He is calling a single, a specific person to do something for his glory. Okay? So it means that being a disciple is an individual responsibility. It's a specific calling. So that's why when you come to learn about the kingdom, it's not about what other people is talking to you. It's not about other people's opinion. It's not about because you've heard from others. It means that it's really you are the one deciding to be a disciple of God. Okay? So that is the number one quality of a kingdom disciple. Number two is available. Another quality of a kingdom disciple, you are available. What do you mean by available? In the verse that we just read, so likewise whosoever he be of you that forsaketh, okay, forsaketh not all. When we say forsaketh, from the Greek word apostaso, means apo means off, and tasso, to arrange. In other words, to set apart or to renounce. It means that when you are available, when you want to become a disciple of the kingdom, then you leave all that you carry. You don't allow stuff to control your life. So you're making yourself willing or ready at all times. You're not hooked by anything or by anybody. In other words, you make yourself free. You make yourself available all the time. It means that you are a different person. You are always ready to do God's will. Remember, God owns your time. In Luke chapter 19 verse 18, but they all alike began to make excuses. So Jesus was talking about the kingdom of God is like the man inviting people on a banquet. But then suddenly, some people, these people that the man invited on a banquet, they have lots of excuses. They are busy. Some said, I bought a field, so I cannot go. Others say, I just got married, so I cannot go. Other ones said, I bought 5 yoke of oxen. So he has lots of excuses. If you want to be a disciple of the kingdom, do not make lots of excuses. When God directs you to do this right now, to learn this right now, do not make any excuses. Instead, be available, because the Lord will use only the one who is not too busy for the Lord's agenda. Make sure you manage your time wisely. You have a good time management. That's very important, because most of us, we have lots of things that we are doing, but we are not really sure if it is the thing that matters the most for the kingdom of God, for the purpose of the Lord in you. So in Luke chapter 14 verse 2, go out quickly into the street. So it was talking about the man who was preparing a banquet, and then the people, the invited guests, were so busy, they're not available. And then the man said, go out quickly into the street. It means that it is really the kingdom agenda is really a very important thing, that you should not say, I'll just do that later, I'll just obey that later. No, it doesn't need any procrastination. Most of us, especially Filipino, we tend to procrastinate in doing the things that God wants us to do. We tend to say, I will just do that tomorrow. Instead, even if right now you still have the capability to do the thing. So make sure you're able to have a time management. Go out quickly into the streets, alleys of the town. And then another thing is, as an available person, you need to prioritize. So Matthew 4:20, at once they left their nets and followed him. their nets are their way of livelihood, source of income. But then, because of the kingdom, it means the kingdom has the purpose of why you live. Sometimes we're just busy in earning livelihood, earning money for us to survive. But there is something that the Lord is calling you to do, His purpose in you and for you. And maybe he is now calling you to rise up from the just surviving life into doing something He has really called you to do. So you need to leave those things that hooks you from doing the what is really right for you and for God's purpose for you. Okay? A kingdom disciple is available. And the third quality of a kingdom disciple is teachable. This is very important. Disciple means matites. It means that it's a learner or a pupil, the one who follows one's teaching. So here, the teaching that we are following is the teaching of the kingdom that the Lord Jesus was teaching. In other words, here in the verse that we read, so likewise, whatsoever he be of you that forsaketh not all he hath, he cannot be my disciple. When we talk about my, Jesus owns his disciple. The kingdom of God knows his own disciple. It means that there is a learner, there's a kingdom learner. It means that he has a people who follows his teaching. In other words, if you are a teachable person, you are willing to learn. If you're a disciple, you need to be willing to learn. You need to be a seeker. Okay, as Jesus was in Matthew 24 verse 3, as Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives, his disciples came to him privately and said, "Tell us, when will this happen? What will be the sign that you are coming again?" It means that they, when they heard Jesus teaching about the coming back again of the Son of Man, the signs, they just did not hear it and then just despise it. No, instead they were interested. They truly went to Jesus and asked. And in Matthew 4:34, explaining everything privately to his disciples. Why did Jesus explain privately? Because the disciples are seekers. They are learners. They really wanted to learn. They really inquired Jesus, what does it mean? Okay, so it means that the disciple is willing to learn, and the disciple also is willing to follow, willing to obey. According to John 10:27, my sheep hear my voice and I know them and they follow me. So it's not just that you learn, whatever you learn, you obey. We obey, we do. In 1 Corinthians 11, Mark 8:34, take up his cross and follow me. It means that there is a denying of our old self and then follow the commandments of the Lord. Then in 1 Corinthians 11 verse 1, be imitators of me as I am Christ. So a disciple is imitating the qualities of Christ. Now, being a kingdom disciple is not just being a member of any organization. It has, according to Jesus, it has three qualities. What are those qualities? A kingdom disciple must be single. And then, a kingdom disciple is available. And a kingdom disciple is teachable. If you have those three things, then you are a kingdom disciple. If you don't have those qualities, then you are not qualified to be a kingdom disciple. So, for us, it takes an individual, a kingdom disciple. Being a kingdom disciple, it takes an individual who is prioritizing the kingdom, willing to give up everything, precious or costly, everything that he treasures in his life in order to follow the kingdom of God.